Mars. It is the fourth planet in the solar system. Its very namesake is the Roman god of war due to its blood-red, iron-based soil. It may not be as hostile as Venus, but there are still plenty of dangers. Notably the fact that you can't just go there anytime you want. So, why should we go to Mars? Hello Earthlings, whether we have a craft that can get to the Martian orbit or not, none of us can just go to Mars anytime we want. Unless we could reach extremely high speeds. Not warp speed, but more than we could with chemical rockets, definitely. This is because Earth and Mars are in two completely separate orbits. The Earth orbits at a solar altitude of 150 million kilometers at 30 kilometers per second, while Mars orbits at a solar altitude of between 200 and 250 million kilometers at a speed of just 24 kilometers per second. So that means you'll have to wait for Earth and Mars to come into alignment, and as of the time of this video's publishing, this won't happen for a while. You can see how the planets are currently lined on theplanetstoday.com. And once you get there, there are a whole bunch of threats. Notably how at Martian sea level, the air is as thin as it is on Earth at 30,000 meters. All the dangers aside, Mars is not the boring planet the New York Times described as, well, boring in 1965. Sure, Mount Everest is a huge mountain, but Olympus Mons on Mars is twice as tall. This massive 600-kilometer diameter shield volcano is so huge that it can nearly cover all of France, or at least most of it. The summit is also 22 kilometers high. On Earth, you would need a spacesuit to survive at that altitude. On Mars? Well, okay, you'd need a spacesuit anywhere on Mars. Olympus Mons is not Mars's only amazing geographical feature, though. Mars also has a huge canyon. Here's the Grand Canyon in Arizona, here on Earth, in case you didn't know which planet Arizona is on. It is 446 kilometers long, up to 30 kilometers wide, and can attain depths of nearly 2 kilometers. It attracts 5 million tourists every year, mainly because, well, people can visit it. But Mars has a bigger canyon. It's called Vallis Marineris. And where is it? Well, right here. Really, it's visible from wherever you can see Mars in detail. It is huge, as seen by its obligatory comparison with the lower 48 states. Or for European viewers, here it is compared to Europe, and now Australia. And here's China, in case I somehow get Chinese viewers, which unfortunately might not happen anytime soon. Vallis Marineris is the solar system's true Grand Canyon, and it is only surpassed in length by the Baltus Vallis on Venus. Vallis Marineris is 4,000 kilometers long, 200 kilometers wide, and up to 7 kilometers deep. It's not just the geographical features, though. Mars could easily provide humanity's second home, especially before we find a Class M planet. It will be difficult, but we might even be able to terraform it. Sure, it will probably take around 500 years and cost trillions of dollars, although with inflation included that would probably be quadrillions of dollars. It may not seem very habitable to us, but it's certainly better than Mercury and Venus. Mercury's day is 59 Earth days long, and its daylight temperature is 430 degrees Celsius. But its nighttime temperature is negative 173 degrees Celsius. Because it has no atmosphere, and if it has no atmosphere, I'm pretty sure it has no CO2 to trap heat. Venus has a runaway greenhouse effect from volcanoes, so its average temperature is 460 degrees Celsius. To put that in comparison, lead would melt at that temperature. Mars's average surface temperature is negative 60 degrees Celsius, but those are just averages. If I told you that Earth's average temperature is 14 degrees Celsius, would you believe me? Chances are you won't, even though that's actually true. But in places like Death Valley and the Sahara, you could prove me wrong with temperatures that can get to 55 degrees Celsius. And also in Antarctica, which has reached temperatures as low as negative 89 degrees Celsius. Mars can reach temperatures of an unusually comfortable 20 degrees Celsius in the equatorial summer, but the polar winters can go down to negative 125 degrees Celsius. So, bottom line, we're not going to the poles, no question about it. The day-night cycle actually won't be anything you'll just have to get used to either, actually. This is because Mars's day is just 1 hour longer than Earth's 24-hour days. So, bottom line, if you want to have a whole new hour to sleep in each day, just move to Mars. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, then please like this video. We really won't know if you enjoyed it or not without your like or dislike if you didn't enjoy it. Also, be sure to subscribe to us and share this video. Would you like to suggest future topics for KhAnubis Explains? Please, feel free to do so. I await your suggestions. Well, and maybe some subscriptions too.